Hello and welcome to GoFalot Equipment News as we report on the latest models of Mizuno irons that will be part of their range in 2009 and 2010. First up is the Mizuno MP62 iron, which is based on the most requested adjustments from Mizuno's tour workshops. It has simple looks, but combines some new technology with the personal grinds of Mizuno tour players such as Luke Donald and Jonathan Bird. The MP62 iron features a minimal offset and a versatile sole plate, together with a redesigned trailing edge to promote crisp ball striking. The external and internal muscle bar, known as the dual muscle, was developed following extensive research into vibration and frequency analysis. This places mass behind the impact area for increased feel and has allowed for a centrally located center of gravity and consistent sweet spot height on the face. The Mizuno MP62 irons are another very good set of irons from Mizuno, and if you're looking for a new set, then we would recommend trying them out. If, however, you have the MP60s or MP32s that this model is designed to replace, then we're not so sure you should upgrade. We really like the cut muscle styling of the previous models, and the dual muscle style of the MP62s seems a little bland by comparison and reminiscent of the MP30s for those of you old enough to remember them. The MP62 irons feel a little heavier in the sole, as the extra weight of the dual muscle design puts more weight behind the ball and lower for that extra forgiveness. However, they do perform well, and those who are looking for a good forged iron with more forgiveness than blades could do worse than check these out. Next up is the Mizuno MP52 iron, which integrates a dual muscle pocket cavity to deliver an uncompromising balance of shot making and forgiveness. Mizuno have deepened the centre of gravity by milling twin crescents into the back of the MP52 head, thereby delivering increased stability from off-centre hits while staying hidden from the golfer at address. This works well and gives the MP52 iron the classic clean profile, which is enhanced by the blending of the cavity from being open to closed as you move down through the irons in the set. The dual muscle of the central impact bar and secondary muscle pad combine to ensure that both feel and feedback are delivered to professional expectations. Designed to bring stability and forgiveness to a shot maker's iron, the MP52 represents the future of design, combining game improvement technologies within the smaller, more versatile club head. The MP52 also has a dual camber sole that reduces drag from increased sole width and is grain flow forged for solid feel and distance control. The Mizuno MP52 irons are another great iron from Mizuno, and it's a major innovation for them to put essentially a forgiving cavity in a better player's iron. When you hit them, you can feel the weight lower and further back in the head, and this does make them very easy to play with. The heads are more forgiving, they still feel great, and the trajectory is still very good. Mizuno say the MP52 irons sit in between the MP57s and the MX range. Certainly, if you're a high single figure handicap golfer and you want forgiveness in a more compact head, the MP52 irons would be the ones for you. However, in our view, we'd be tempted to go for the MP57 irons, which are classic MP irons for performance, or even the new MX200 irons, which offer even more forgiveness. The Mizuno MX200 irons sees a new development in forging forgiveness with the introduction of Y-Tune. A milled deep pocket cavity enhances the large sweet spot even further and allows the MX200 to match cast irons for forgiveness and increases the effectiveness of the sweet area by moving it towards the toe area of the club, giving extra distance on mishits. The Mizuno MX200 irons are a big improvement on the MX25 irons. Not only do they look better, but the Y-Tune design on the back of the head does make them very forgiving. The other major benefit is that the trajectory is excellent throughout the set, and the ball does not balloon off the face despite the cavity pocket on the back of the club head. This weighting does mean that the lofts on the Mizuno MX200 irons are a little stronger than the corresponding MP irons. However, the feel is almost as good as the MP irons, and the forged heads offer great feedback combined with lots of confidence from the oversized heads. We really like the short irons, where the cavity has been reduced and is covered up to give a sleek look and great feedback. In our view, the Mizuno MX200 irons are one of the best forged irons around for mid-handicappers, so try them out. Rounding out the range is Mizuno's MX100 Iron, which combines Y-tune performance with an even bigger pocket cavity that pushes the centre of gravity low and deep to produce a higher ball flight. The even larger effective hitting area is more stable, and like the MX200, the Y-tune's cavity pad expands the sweet spot higher into the toe section of the club. The Mizuno MX100s replace the MX19 and are essentially a larger version of the MX200 irons. The heads are not only a bit longer, but they also have a wider sole and a larger and deeper cavity behind the head. All this is aimed at the higher handicapper who needs a little extra help with their irons, and we are pleased to say that they work. The large cavity is visible at address in some of the longer irons, which can be a little off-putting, but the forgiveness of the MX100 heads soon has you forgetting all about this. Even on off-centre hits, these Mizuno irons were forgiving with no loss of distance. However, if you struggle with your long irons, then you may want to drop the 4-iron for the excellent MX Fly High utility instead. Unusually for a set of irons these days, the MX100 irons come with a sand iron included, and it's actually pretty good. The wide sole will get you out of the heaviest sand or rough, and the feel was pretty good too. The MX100 irons are cast rather than the forged MX200 irons, and although they don't feel quite as nice, they still give plenty of feel, even if they do seem a little heavier from that bigger cavity. Overall, a good set of irons for the high handicapper who wants to improve. Finally, the Mizuno MX Fly High Utility Club has been launched as a high handicapper's version of the MP Fly High as part of what Mizuno call their DLIR, or Direct Long Iron Replacement Strategy. It does exactly what it says on the tin and provides a direct replacement for the 3, 4 or 5 iron in any MX set by embracing Y-tune technology to provide a high flying and soft landing club. A unique crown coupled with exact iron lengths provide the option of adjusting lie angles to suit custom fitted Mizuno iron sets. The use of Y-tune technology and increased sole thickness extends the MX Fly High's effective hitting area much higher into the toe and combines with a little bit extra heel weighting to encourage a draw bias. The Mizuno MX Fly High Utility Club is an excellent rescue club which will fit well into any MX set of clubs. The long, large club head gives you lots of confidence, yet the feel at impact is very solid. We were pleasantly surprised by the trajectory of the shots from our 21 degree 3-iron replacement version. Not only did this keep the ball flight from ballooning up, but it was easy to shape shots if required, as the club feels more like an iron than a wood. Unless you really love your long irons, we would advise you to get a couple of these rescue clubs in your bag, as they can be custom made to replace a 3, 4 or 5 iron. Another great hybrid club and our pick of this year's launches from Mizuno. That's all for now, but if you'd like to find out more and to compare prices on all Mizuno products, please visit our website, golfalot.com.